Hey there, friends. I have another quick morning practice for you today. This one is going to be on the active side and maybe have a few unusual things thrown in there, so expect the unexpected. Hopefully you do that already with my classes. You don't necessarily have to have any props, but you could have a block handy just in case. So I'm gonna face the camera for this beginning portion, but you can stand near the top of your mat, right? So just feet hip width-ish or so. We're just gonna kind of swing the arms and kind of sway from side to side. Don't overthink it. And then let's start to kind of slow that down so things can come to a halt. And then we're gonna put hands on hips and kind of make some big circles with the hips. And you can adjust your foot width. If it feels better to go a little wider, you can. Switch directions. You might hear some cracking and popping. I can hear that for sure. All right, and then I'm gonna take my feet just about hip width, like I would in mountain pose. So if you wanna find mountain pose feet, and we're gonna warm up the feet, coming up onto the toes and then rocking back to the heels and just kind of rocking back and forth a little bit there. Okay, and then we're gonna kind of circle on the edges of the feet. So from the toes, roll out and back to the heels and then in, right? So you're kind of taking that in a circle. And then try switching directions with that circling. A little bit awkward, a little bit of a balance challenge. All right, I'm gonna move to the top of my mat for this next one here. All right, I'm gonna take the arms up and I'm gonna do a little bit of spinal movement from here. So kind of thinking toward a back bend, but being mindful that, you know, we're just getting started, so it doesn't have to be too far. And then I'm gonna kind of round as I dive forward, and you can do whatever you want with your hands. You can make sort of a diving hand shape if that feels better. Bend your knees as much as you need to, round your back on the way down, and then bend your knees more if you like when you get to the bottom, and then we'll stay rounded as we come up. And then reach back up, lengthen, and then move in the opposite direction, back bending, and then forward, rounding down. Round up, lengthen at the top, and then extend. Just go down one more time. And back up. And from this extended place, let's go ahead and take our hands kind of behind the back or on the hips, however that works for you, and give that back bend a little bit of support and hold it for a moment. All right, let's come up to neutral and we'll start working on the legs and some balance just a little bit here. I'm gonna lift the left knee up and down a few times, working that hip flexor. Or those hip flexors, right? There's more than one. Okay, and then from that lifted position, I'm gonna do a slow circle, right? Take that knee out, start to angle it down, and then reach it back, and then forward. And then back, I'll switch directions, and out. And it starts to angle back up as it comes back forward. From that forward position, I'll try straightening-ish the leg forward, bending it back and forth a few times. much about what that lifted leg is doing. It can be more relaxed. And we're going to find sort of warrior three leg position and pulse that standing leg, bending and straightening back and forth a few times, hopefully feeling the glutes. Okay, let's land on the ball of that back foot, and then we're going to straighten both legs and then bend both knees. Straighten both legs, bend both knees. Let's do a couple more. And then from that straight legged position, try to square your hips a little bit more forward. Lengthen, and we're going to lower, not quite halfway, just until we feel something on the back of that front leg. Come back up, and let's bend just the right knee so we're in more of a quote-unquote proper lunge. And let's do some big arm circles here. Switch directions. Alright, I'm going to let my arms land out in front. Press the palms together and really feel all those muscles, outer shoulder activate. And then I'm going to trace my left arm with my right hand, peeling, opening back to the right and back forward and to the left and back forward. Let's take both arms up, and then let's grab the left wrist and give a little pull to the right for a side bend. Release the side bend, step forward, mountain pose. Let's switch. Right leg, knee lifts, up and down a few times. Keep that knee up, slow circle, out, angles down, moves back behind, and forward. Switching directions, down, and back, and out, and then angles back up as it comes back forward. Extend the leg and bend back and forth a few times. All right, and then we'll go toward that warrior three leg position, keeping that lifted leg relaxed. Let's work the standing leg, bending and straightening a few times. Landing on the ball of the back foot, all right, and then we'll straighten both legs, bend both knees, straighten. And bend. Balance might be a little challenging, right? And then from that straight legged position, long spine, take a little bit of a fold. Come back up, bend just the left knee so we're in a lunge, arm circles. Switch directions. Arms forward, palms together. Give them a press. Left arm peels back. Turn. Back forward. Right arm peels back. Open. And back forward. Both arms reach up. Grab the right wrist. A little pull to the left side bend. Release that side bend. Let's keep arms up as we step forward and then forward fold all the way down. Inhale up about halfway, get long. Exhale, fold. Let's step into plank. All right, let's just get that plank set up really well. Hands about shoulder width or so, spread the fingers. And we're just gonna do a little bit of weight shifting front to back. So pushing with the toes. So we're working the wrists a little bit more. When we go forward. All
And then I'm gonna let my hips kind of roll to the right, getting set up for side plank, but keep the left hand down for a moment. And then I'm gonna peel the left arm up into side plank. And peel back down to plank. And then start to roll lower body to the left. Peel the right arm up. And back down to plank. And we're gonna lower all the way down. From here, release your toes. Let's do some baby cobra lifting. Up and down. Feel those back muscles working. And this time, as we lift, push into the hands and let's see if we can pull up to up dog and then downward facing dog. Okay, let's get the right foot forward and we're gonna set up a warrior two-like back foot, which is parallel or so to the back of the mat. We're not doing warrior two just yet though. We're gonna go to, I call it straight-legged reverse warrior, or you could call it maybe reverse triangle. I don't know, side bend toward the back leg, front leg is straight. And then we're gonna bend the knee and reach forward into side angle. Straighten, reach up, bend, reach forward. Straighten, and up, bend, reach forward, straighten and up. From here, keep the lift, bend the knee, reverse warrior, straighten, reach forward, triangle. So sort of the reverse of that, if that makes sense. One more time. From triangle, we're gonna meet in the middle, warrior two. And we're gonna attempt to move from warrior two into a lunge twist. So we'll kind of do an arm circle-ish kind of movement as we spin to the ball of the back foot. Left hand goes down, right arm goes up. And then we'll try to reverse that back to warrior two. Back to our sort of twist and a lunge. Warrior two, a lunge twist. Warrior two, last time. A lunge twist. From here, let's take the back knee down. Lift the right toes, let that foot angle out, roll that leg open, reach your right arm back and just kind of let your chest open. And then we're gonna take both hands down and kind of scooch this leg over a bit for pigeon. And we'll take a little rest here. If you wanted to have a block to rest on, you could. Notice your breathing. Mine certainly got a little trickier. Ooh. From here, we'll press up and step into plank. Inhale, exhale all the way down. Inhale, lift up through baby cobra to up dog. Exhale, down dog. All right, second side. Left foot forward, back foot down, parallel-ish. The back of the mat. We'll go into that sort of straight-legged reverse warrior and then bend the knee and reach forward side angle without your hip popping like mine. All right, lift up and straighten, bend and reach forward. Lift up and straighten, bend and reach forward. Lift up, straighten. From there, stay lifted and bend your knee, reverse warrior.
And then straighten, reach forward into triangle. Let's try that a few times. All right. And then we'll meet in the middle, warrior two. Going from there into lunge twist, right? Sweeping the arms, ball the back foot, and then trying to reverse that. We'll try a few. Right, balance can be a little tricky. And then from that lunge twist, we'll lower the back knee. We'll lift the left toes, turn it out, open the leg, reach back and let the chest open. And then we'll take that hand down and kind of scooch into pigeon. Take a moment. Check your breathing. Here, instead of going into plank and doing, you know, some more traditional flow, we're going to go into Sphinx. So we'll kind of take that pigeon leg back and come onto our bellies, elbows under the shoulders approximately, palms down in front. We're going to do some spinal movement here, right? So this is inhale, we're in spinal extension. So we exhale, we're going to move in the opposite direction, but not quite all the way to flexion, but toward flexion. So lifting the belly and the hips and the thighs, and you can kind of tuck your chin a little bit here if you like, and then inhale, lower back down. Exhale. Inhale. So hopefully feeling your core when we do that lift, right? Because it's definitely forearm plank-like. And if you wanted to, you could lift the knees as well, but see if you can maybe stay on the tops of your feet, so more of a pointed toe plank. Let's do one more lift. Lower down, wiggle the hips. Let's press back into a nice child's pose position. And maybe, if you like, adding a little upper arm stretch. Prayer hands out in front, elbows down, and it's kind of scooching forward.
Head down. Prayer hands come to the back of your neck. Breathe.
Let's release from there. Come on up. And you can just come to a comfortable seat and take a breath, take a moment. Notice how things are feeling. Whew, that was a tough one. Thanks for joining me, and I look forward to practicing with you again soon. Have a great day.